This video is part of the certification program, SABA, Spreadsheet Applications in Business Analytics. Please contact if you want to apply for the certificate program, or for more details.
Then we'll just go and talk about the other function, which is your custom. So many a times what happens is that, you know, you really want your data to be represented in a very different manner. So how to use the custom function or the custom tab over here, I'll just quickly tell you. For example, let's talk about the number formatting. So what I really want is that I have this number over here. You can see this 1, 2, 3, 4. I want this to be displayed under red color. And what I want is the dollar symbol to be added. Okay. And then what I want is maybe certain brackets to be added. So what I can do is I can either go one by one and change it by doing it red color and then putting a dollar symbol in terms of, you know, a dollar symbol over here. And then since I don't have any function, what I can do is I need to manually add the brackets. Okay, so now the moment I added bracket, it understood that it is a minus or negative value. So, but I don't want this to be displayed like this. What I really want is that it should come in red color, but it should come as in this format. It's just that it should be in red in color. But you can see that, you know, the moment I have added this dollar symbol, it is taking it as general because it is considering it as a string value. So how to do that? Let's do certain custom formatting for all these things. So what I am doing is, you remember the last webinar we talked about clear function. So I'm just clearing all so that there is no formatting left over here. So we'll just quickly go to this shortcut. I have this number over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. I have entered. I'll just go to the custom one. So many a times you will see a lot of custom already available here. Okay. So if it is available, it's okay. You can select one of them. If I'm working on something and, you know, if I've already created, you might see that that custom has already been added to my list. But what I'm going to do is I'll just show it to you how to do that. I'll remove this general. So whatever color I want, guys, this is very important. So whatever I'm adding over here has certain, you know, significance. For example, if I want to add a color, I have to give this square bracket. Okay, close the bracket. Then what I want is I want the number to be displayed under brackets. So I'll just as of now, just try to understand if I have given red, what is going to happen. Let's go and see what are the results. Click OK. You can see that the number is being displayed as red color. Okay. So now we'll try to add on more features to the same number. I'll go to the custom. I can see that there is this red color. So I am just removing this general because it is still not read the number as a number. It was still reading it as a string. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add bracket. Close the bracket. That's it. I'm not doing anything. Let's see what happens. It is only giving me the brackets. So what has happened now? It is not reading that number. It is. So I have to specify that there is no bracket. There has to be some number. So what I'm going to do is I have to give 00.00 and close the bracket. So this function or this number is going to give a you know, hint to Excel that there is a number that has to be read and then give it into the brackets. So let's see what happens. Click on OK. So now you can see that it is reading and it is also adding two decimal places to that particular number. If I really want to add more decimal places, the thing what I can do is I can give one more decimal. I can add one more zero to that and click on OK. So you can see it has added one more zero to that. Again, if I want a dollar symbol, what I can do is, it is very simple. You just give a dollar symbol. You just need to type it and click on OK. So now you can see that it has added a dollar symbol and it is reading the number as 1, 2, 3, 4 with 3 decimal places. And it has also added the brackets to the number. So many a times, you know, there are certain requirements where, you know, the report has to be presented in terms of negative values highlighted in different color format, or you want dollar symbol to be added, or if you want, you know, a lot of other decimal places. So in short, if you want to customize your representation of number, you can use this function. I have just given you clue in terms of giving red color, adding brackets, giving a dollar symbol, but you can explore this tab and see what all you can do. So what I'm going to do is I'll quickly show if I really want a blue color, what is going to happen. Go to the custom function again. So instead of giving red, I can just give blue. So you can see that it has changed to blue. Okay. So this is how you can use custom number formatting. So let's talk about the date formatting, how to add the custom date formatting. So I have exhaustive list of, you know, all the employees in the organization. So I have the date of birth of all the, you know, employees in my organization. So this is, I'm just giving a random date. Okay, so I really want to understand what was the day when the person was born. If I just go to this function, date function, I can see that there is no criteria where the day is also added. What I'm trying to say is I really want what day was it, whether it was Monday, whether it was Tuesday, or what day it was. So I can just use a custom date formatting. So how to do that? I'll go to more number formattings, go to custom. So what I can do is I'll just try to add DDD. The moment I have added three D's, it is trying to understand that it is a day. The moment I keep adding, it will increase the entire day. Okay. So if I'm giving 3 D's, the moment I give 2 D's, it means that it has to read only the date. If I give 3 D's, it understands that it is the day it is talking about. And if I give, the moment I enter the 4th D, it will give the entire day. Okay. So now once I have given that, I'm just saying that please separate it with a comma. Okay. If I give a comma, I can give space. Then I want the day. Okay. Then I am giving a space, then I want month. If I give double M, if I give single M, it is giving as 7th, that is July. If I give double M, it is understanding that 07 has to be added. The moment I give the third M, it will read in the short form, that is the 3 letters. If I give the 4th M, it will read the entire month. So let's keep it to 3 or 2, okay? So I'm just adding 3 because it is giving a more better result. And I want a comma. Let's say I'm just adding a comma and then I want the year. The moment I give Y, it is going to read the 2 last, you know, year. Like for example, 1986, it will read as 86. If I'm giving, you know, 2001, it will only read as 1. The moment I give the second Y, the result is still same. And if I give the third Y, it will read the entire year. So whether I give 3 Ys or if I give the 4 Ys, the result is going to be same. And I'll just click on OK. Okay, so now you can see that it was a Sunday, 13th July 1986 is what it is being read as. But earlier, then if I go to any of the date formats over here, I can see none of the dates which I really want to use has the day included in that particular cell formatting. Okay, fine. So now I have given you this. If you want to explore, please try different cell formattings and see how the date function is going to, how it is going to work. So you can explore different methods. So it's up to you. Now let's talk about the custom time formatting. Okay, so I'm just giving a 09, this is 30th minute and 34 seconds. So if I really want, the time functions to be added, how to do that? This is also quite simple. So just go to custom. You can see it is here. You can see that hour, hour, minute, minute, and second is being displayed. If you want this to be displayed as AM and PM, you can use either one of the functions which are already available under custom. Okay. But if you want a different style to be represented, you can just add as per your requirement. Okay. If I just don't want the seconds to be represented, you can use this function. Just see what happens. You can see it is coming as 9:30 AM. Okay. So this is how you can explore it. If you just want the hour, you can just add the hour. If you want only the minutes to be displayed, you can use only the minutes, so on and so forth. Similarly, if I want PM, I'm just giving a 16:09. And let's see what happens if I use the same formatting. I'm using the format painter. And you can see that it has added PM to the data. Okay, fine. So now let's talk about the custom currency format. So you remember that when I was talking about the custom currency format over here, we can also use the custom currency format by using any of the functions. Like I'll just give a currency or give a number over here. So it's 5,000. Okay. Guys, you might have seen, many a times if you see the prices in terms of US dollars or the pounds, or if you see euros. So you can see that, many a times these commas are being used as different, commas are being used as separators. So I'll just tell you, like the commas that we talk about is 1,000 separator. We talk about in terms of, Indian currency. But in many countries, this comma is also being read as your dot. That is nothing but your cents value or the paisa value in terms of Indian currency. So many a times, if you want this separator to be used in a different style, you can definitely go to custom currency format and change it as per your requirement. So I'll just show it to you. Like I have this value as 5,000, but this is not 5,000. What I really want is this is 50 euro. So what I'm going to do is I'll go to number. I'll go to currency, custom. And I'll just, you can see that this is being read as rupee. Okay. If I want this, I can use this one. Let's see if what happens if I use this one. The rupee symbol has been added with a 1,000 separator with two decimal places. But what if I just want a different custom format? What I can do is go to customs. So this hash is nothing but your numbers. You can use this hash. So what I'm doing is I'm just adding the dollar symbol. I'm giving the hash symbol. I'm using the dot over here, giving two hash with or two zeros as to represent the decimal places. Let's see what happens. You can see that it has come as, okay, it has taken two decimals. Wait, I'll quickly change it. Okay, it is taking two decimals because it was being read as two decimals. So I'll just remove one of them. You can see it is coming as 5,000.$. Okay. So this is how you can change it. And you can see what you can do with your custom formatting. Okay. See, if I just go and use the custom format, guys, you will understand or you will learn when you are trying to explore other functions. So what if I just give a star? Let's see what happens. You can see that, you know, lot of values are coming. So star is nothing but it is going to add lot of numbers. So you have to really explore this particular tab and see what is going to happen. So the hash, I have given you the value, what it is used for. The zeros are being used for the decimal ones. You will not use the decimal zeros for the before decimal values. Okay.
This video is part of the certification program, SABA, Spreadsheet Applications in Business Analytics. Please contact if you want to apply for the certificate program, or for more details.